So we can store a binary tree very conveniently into an array. Therefore, all we need to do is to traverse the tree by the depth and then pull down the values. So here we start at depth 0, put down 100 as the first element in the array. Then we go to the next steps. So we put down 19 and 36, then 17, 3, 25 and 1, and 2 and 7. So that's a very nice way of storing a tree. And there's a direct translation between an arrow position and the position inside our tree that is written over here. So there is also another way of serializing, of course, a tree to an array. Here we use the in order traversal. So we go to the left nodes, start with the leftmost node, then we put the parent down and so on. Parent, we put down 7 and we put down its parent and so on. So in this mapping, the position of the root is the center of the array, and the left neighbor of this node is basically the mid between 0 and the center and so forth. So that's really similar to our binary search, so there's a lot of analogy between this. It is suboptimal a little bit because you cannot extend the tree easily by extending the array. While this mapping over here, you can always add a new level of depthness, and then basically you add at the end more elements of the tree. To wrap up today's talk, trees are really elementary data structures. They're useful for searches, expressions, extraction of maximum with heaps. They can be implemented in arrays or using pointers. Complete and balanced trees store our elements. For n elements, a search tree has a depth of log n, which is very good for searching. We have talked about different types of traversals: pre-order, in-order, and post-order. So, as those are really elementary data structures, I hope you will engage a little bit in the discussion and you try out the codes that are in the repository. All those codes, of course, that we looked at today are in our repositories, so you can run the code, you can manipulate it, and try to understand them. Wish you a great week.